I selected Adam for strength training for my student of the month. it's interesting, I have Adam two times in one day. Now typically, if you have a student two times in one day, it's not for the reason that I have Adam. Adam is actually trying to graduate early. So I have him second period and 10th period. And it's interesting to see because I don't consider myself the best morning person, so I come in and I say, Adam, I'm probably gonna notice a lot of differences with my teaching. And he says, I do, Ms. Myers, a lot of enthusiastic 10th period. But now back to Adam, I want to tell you why he's the student of the month. And he's someone who's been in my class for each semester he's been at LT. It feels like I've had him for more. He really goes beyond what is required. He's not just typically fit, he's not just typically a hard worker, he's not just typical as a good student. And he goes above and beyond. He's taking my core strength training to a different level. He's talking about the science of exercise, the physiology of weightlifting. He wants to know more. He wants to, you know, start his own gym. He's really interested in you know, the body, kinesiology. And I find that really cool, not in a teacher's pet way, but just, wow, this guy really does want to go to the next level, and he's practicing what he preaches in class. I've caught him at the end of class talking to other students who are like, I can't get a six-pack, how do I get a flat stomach, things like that. And Adam's always chirping with them, not in that annoying way, in a very humble way, just saying, hey, try this. Hey, do this. And he's very well-liked for his humility. He carries himself in a very calm demeanor. You wouldn't know all the things that I'm seeing if you're just his peer. They really have a great deal of respect for him. And it's very fun to watch throughout the semester, and I get to see it twice a day, which has been a true pleasure. It's funny, I say, you know, we're taking this more of a college course now, Adam. You're now my teacher's assistant, because of course I'm traveling from facility to facility all day long. I forget things. And so Adam is at least running an errand for me back to the PE office to grab something I forgot, or getting fitness cards or pencils, and he does it with a smile on his face. And he does it very calmly, is not annoyed like I do to many other students who I make those requests to. So it truly has been a pleasure for everything he has, his maturity, his eagerness, his curiosity, all those things that I'm sure all the students here have in terms of attributes. So thank you, Adam, for making my semester pretty darn good so far.
Our next presenter from our Business Education Department, Mr. George Lowen.
Out among the other students, I can best explain through two examples. First of all, we had one activity a few weeks ago where I had students read an article from the Wall Street Journal. Remember this?
Yeah.
a man in Massachusetts had fallen into some hard times, made some bad financial decisions, and was in really kind of bad shape. So we talked about what did he do wrong, what should he have done differently. If you were him, what would you do? So a couple days later, Sergio comes in and says, yeah, I called the guy. He's a little better. yeah, I'm sure he did. Yeah, okay, great. I said, can you bring some written proof that you've done this? So next day or two, he brings in an email, printed out, saying, here's an email from the guy. I interviewed him. Here's his answers. He's doing better. Oh, my gosh. So, full surprise. And the other example is we also do a resume in class. And students are told, keep it to one page. Most students don't have a problem, they don't have a lot of experience, so keeping it one page is not a big issue. Sergio comes in with, is this okay, Mr. Long? Two full pages. And I'm looking at it thinking, we gotta cut it down. There's some stuff we probably can take out of there. I'm looking through it, and there's all these leadership conferences, all these clubs, activities, awards. And I think he's the first student in recent memory I've had where I basically said, I'd leave it alone. It's good, it's all good, keep it two pages. And I don't often do that. So. Two examples of what makes them really outstanding and going above and beyond, and very happy to present this award to them.
Congratulations, Sergio. Next, from our music department, I'd like to welcome up Ms. Jane Ewing and her nominee.
morning, my name is Jane Ewing and I teach orchestra at LT, and this is Robert Watkins, he plays cello. Robert is our student of the month, or student of the 4 years. he's a senior, he's been in orchestra for 4 years, and that's the greatest thing in the world, that I get to see these kids for all 4 years. Robert makes orchestra better just by being in orchestra. He's a snowball leader, he's an athlete, and he just makes us all cooler in the orchestra because he's in orchestra. And he's a lover of classical music. He's always, there's a grand piano in the orchestra room, and he plays every morning. He serenades us while we come into class. Whatever pieces we're doing in the orchestra, he buys them and puts them on his iPod. So he's always studying the music, not just his own part, but he's studying the entire symphony or whatever we're doing. And he's always hunting for things for us to play. And it's not the latest video game music either. It's, hey, I heard this great Brahms, I heard this great Rachmaninoff, we should do it. So he's just so enthusiastic about orchestra, it's infectious. Thirdly, my nickname for him is Long and Lanky. As you can show us your hands, Robert. So it's great for playing cello. I mean, it's just gifted physically to play the cello. He makes that instrument look so small. Every other kid, this instrument looks so big, and they're trying to get around it. And he's like, So he's just all over the cello. And he's always just, he's really in touch with the people around him. If someone's having a bad day, if I'm having a bad day, he'll say, you know, what's wrong, Ms. Ewing? Are you stressed? Which is usually the case. So he'll crack a joke and break the tension, and then we go on with class. And not most importantly, but very importantly, if I need an errand run, I always go to him, because if I have a problem, if some kid needs to go to the nurse or for whatever reason, I know I can send Robert, because he's just very mature and very, he's good, thinks quickly on his feet. So if there's ever a problem, he can always handle it. And he's not afraid to talk to adults, and he's just a very adult person. And he's been a joy to have for 4 years. I can't believe it's been 4 years. And but that's why he's student of the month in orchestra.
Congratulations, Robert. Our next presenter from our science department, Mr. Mark Kaczynski.
Subject. However, conceptual understandings, the mathematical roadblocks, not an issue. Instead, I've witnessed much growth, maturity, resolve, fearlessly asked questions. Time is carefully spent. Basically, the dream of any educator. In fact, she makes me feel like I've done a great job each day. It makes my day that much more special just to have her come into the classroom each day. Above all, she's very personable. She learned a little bit about Indiana University the other day as we had sat and chatted about things other than physics, where she had to go to the restroom at the Runcible Spoon, which is a unique situation one of the top, by the way, top 10 bathroom destinations in the United States. According to the Travel Channel. So if you ever get a chance to go to the Russell School there at Indiana University, and you'll see what we mean. But she's more than that. She's a very divergent thinker. She has well thought out questions that tackle these tricky concepts. Her focus achieves above the norm. She perseveres. She shows the ability to triumph when others might fail. Her motivation and maturity are times. I applaud Josephine for her just being there each day, motivated, ready to learn, ready to ask good questions. And I don't know whether she realizes this, but she is noticed by others in the classroom in terms of her behavior. Won't mention names because I don't want to put those people on the spot, but I have had students mention her role model. So thank you, Joseph.
Congratulations. Our next presenter this morning from our mathematics department is Jennifer Sesniak.
It was pretty early in the year when we were asked to make our selection for Student of the Month, and so I was thinking, well, what kind of behaviors or criteria would I like to recognize? And there are two things that I noticed in Kyle that caused me to select him. The first is that he showed growth in the class over the first three tests that we took, and for many students, statistics, while it's a math class, they will say very early on, wow, it's not like other math classes. We don't have the same kind of homework. There's a lot of writing. You always have to explain. There isn't one right answer. It's not black and white. And for some students, it takes weeks or quarters or maybe even the whole year before they start to catch on to a statistical way of thinking. And Kyle was fortunate enough that I recognize that he has started to see that type of thinking where everything in statistics is gray. There is no right answer as long as you can justify it and you can spin it, to the situation or to the point of view that you want. And so I would like to recognize that that's a skill that he has. And the other thing that I wanted to recognize in Kyle is his ability to work with a myriad of different groupings in class. I feel like some teachers may that you're always searching for the perfect small group combination in class. One day it seems that these two people work really well together, then you put them together the following week and maybe there's some friction. Or maybe the skills don't quite mesh. Or maybe this is an activity that was more physical versus more cerebral. And Kyle, I can put anywhere and he becomes the de facto group leader. And I've really come to appreciate the fact that it doesn't matter what task we have or who you work with, you will keep your peers on task. And you will work together, and it really makes the class more fun to be in and more fun to teach. So thank you.
Our next presenter this morning from our art department is Mary Beth Coffey Sears.
Well, I always get so excited when it's my turn to do Student of the Month in our department. We have a large department, so we rotate it, and it is early in the year. But I have the very fortunate experience this semester that I have students in my intermediate class that I've also had in the beginning. And this is Charlie and Rebecca, and they are both just amazing, each in their own ways. So when I went through my class lists and I was deciding, who am I going to choose, they both stood out, pretty quickly. Charlie is amazing. He's just wonderful in clay. And one of the biggest things that, you know, I try to have the students do is really get a connection to their work so that they realize that what they're producing is an extension of who they are. And that that expression and that communication is key in being a successful artist. And Charlie and Rebecca both do this. They just really connect to the media. They're very serious about their work. Charlie pushes himself beyond what is the expectation. So even if he has, for instance, we're working on membrane bowls, and you know, he had a few bowls that were very good, you know, quite adequate for the requirements of an intermediate level. And he said, I want to still push this further. I want to make mine larger. I want to get this better. I know I can. And he'll do it. And, you know, I'm going to go for it. So Rebecca is so creative and so thoughtful. She approaches her work with wonderful joy. I think that you really enjoy working with the clay, working with your ideas, and expressing yourself. And each of them really help, it's fortunate they're in the same class period, really help that class period just get awake in the morning and get working and kind of keep things moving. Each of them help me with other tasks around the room, loading kilns, helping me set up and take down the extruder, working with other students on the wheel and their teapots, all kinds of things that they just really do that help the classroom flow. And I could not be happier or more proud to give them these awards today.
Our next presenter is from our Student Services Department. I'd like to introduce Ms. Ann Strickland. Unfortunately, her student was not able to be here this morning, but I would like to make sure that she does have an opportunity to share some wonderful things about him.
Hi, I'm Ann Strickland. I'm one of the counselors here at LT. My student is Angel Cruz. He's one of my counselees. Although I've only known Angel a short time, he's made a very deep impression upon me, and for that reason, he's my choice for student of the month. Angel transferred to LT in the spring of 2013 from a suburban high school that borders the city of Chicago following the death of a close family member. Angel didn't have the smoothest transition to LT, as is typical when any student starts school mid-semester, I should say that. Angel hung in there, however, and he never complained. In fact, Angel didn't talk much, and I thought maybe he didn't like me, he's kind of a quiet kid. I wish he was here so you could meet him, but later in the semester, Angel decided to take a summer school course to enhance his familiarity with LT before his senior year. That doesn't happen much. Usually the young kids, like the eighth graders, will take a class going into their freshman year to kind of get familiar with LT. And as the students get older, a lot of times they're taking summer school classes as a makeup for a failure. But that wasn't the case with Angel. He wanted to take a class to further get to know LT. And that was when I really started to see the Angel that I've come to know and admire. This school year, Angel is navigating a challenging schedule, which includes double commuting to our South Campus, both at the beginning and end of the day. And again, not a complaint out of him. In fact, he's enthusiastic, eager to learn, and so very proud of his accomplishments here at LT. He comes to my office at least once a week to check in. And I hear this little light knock at my door, and when I turn around and see that it's Angel, I couldn't be happier. He truly, no matter what kind of day I'm having, when I see that it's Angel at my door, I'm just thrilled. His knowledge for learning, his enthusiasm, he finds happiness in the tiniest and simplest of things, just I light up talking to him. You know, I've worked in schools. This is my 17th year, and I can say that I don't think I've ever met a student like Angel. And again, I've only known him since February, and he's changed me. He's certainly made me a better counselor, and I want to say a better person. So I'm grateful to his mom to bring me into LT, and I wish she was here to congratulate him, but he's my student of the month.
Our final presenter this morning is from our Student Services Department. I'd like to introduce Ms. Heidenbach. She's substituting for Mr. Geddes this morning. He was unable to join us, but he had some wonderful things that he wanted to share about one of his students.
She is Emma has been nominated today for Student of the Month for her hard work and dedication. Student Council has 70 members that come weekly to our student council meetings. Emma is one of our very active student council members. She is hardworking, she is dedicated, she is always there to help us whenever needed. She sometimes comes early, maybe an hour or two before the meeting to see if she can help us get anything ready. She does not hold an officer position, but she is considered by Mr. Geddes and I to be a valuable leader. Whenever Emma is given a task to complete, she goes above and beyond our expectations every time. Last month, we held our first blood drive at North Campus, and Emma quickly volunteered to help us. We had maybe 150 students give blood, and she was in charge of checking all the students in, showing them how to fill out the paperwork, where to go next. She never sat down the whole time. I think she even ate her lunch standing. She's a great asset to student council. Her peers absolutely look up to her, and she is trying to show them how to act, and she's doing a great job at that. She always has a smile on her face also. So congratulations.
That's going to conclude our Student of the Month ceremony through the month of October. But before we leave, I'd like to take a moment to thank some of the following people. I'd like to thank Sodexo for our wonderful breakfast this morning. I'd like to thank Ms. Candy Fay back on the camera from LTTV, who will be providing copies of this available on the school TV station. Additionally, I'd like to also thank again Paul Hunter, our piano player, for getting us started this morning. And lastly, I'd like to thank in the back my assistant, Ms. Sandy Marciniak, who really makes this whole thing possible. She really is the one who gets all the work done. So thank you to all of you. Mr. President, I'd like to say congratulations. You've set yourself apart from other students here at LT with your hard work, commitment, integrity, thoughtfulness, academic success, and leadership, to just name a few of the traits that have been mentioned. And to the parents that are here today, thank you for your continued support, commitment, and guidance. We wouldn't have such fine citizens to recognize today that you hadn't instilled in them these wonderful qualities. Students, as we leave this morning, I am going to ask that you go right outside here in front of the Wall of Fame. We are going to do a group picture for the website, and that will conclude our ceremony this morning. So thank you all very much for coming.